This video is about a toxic teaching of Jehovah's Witness that will send droves of believers to hell in the last days. For a start, I came across two videos on Sadhu Sundar Selvaraj on YouTube some time ago that have everything to do with the topic that I've just mentioned. I'm not here to make any comments on whether I agree or disagree with everything he said in his ministry, but I'm just merely quoting what he said in his two videos.
You know, I was just told by a minister of God in Singapore about a church elder of one of the largest church in Singapore. And the elder spoke with this minister of God that I know, a friend of mine, said, it is nothing wrong to take the mark of the beast. He is an elder in the largest church in Singapore. For the elder to speak like that, what must the church be teaching? Right? This minister friend of mine was shocked to hear this. He said, what do you mean it's okay? Yeah, he said, of course it's okay. Because God knows our hearts. Wrong. You see, this is the ploy of the devil.
Ago, a pastor in Singapore, he shared with me a very shocking incident. He had lunch with one of the elders of the one of the largest church in that nation. And over lunch, this elder told this pastor, it's nothing wrong to take the mark of the beast. It's perfectly all right. You can take the mark of the beast. You will not go to hell. And this pastor was shocked to hear that word coming from this elder of a very, very large church in that nation. So if the elder believes that, probably the whole church believes that. Mm-hmm. So we have many, many Christians like that who believe that.
Brother Sadhu, have you folks been hearing that? Mm-hmm. This is a new doctrine that's being taught all over the world. I'm shocked to hear you say that because I don't think we've talked about it on our show.
We have not.
Because we're hearing it. We're starting to hear it, mm-hmm. the rustling. And to hear you say that you actually talked to somebody that in a major church, mm-hmm. they're just saying, it's okay. What's going on? Mm. Are we being set up? Is Satan so powerful now that he's working on the minds of the church people to deceive them? He wants them in hell with him.
Are you shocked by what you heard in the two videos? Although Sadhu Sundar Selvaraj didn't mention the name of the church, I've come to the conclusion with 99% certainty that the church referred to must be New Creation Church. Many of you may also be aware that the other largest churches in Singapore do not hold to such reckless views that it is nothing wrong to take the mark of the beast. It's perfectly all right. You can take the mark of the beast. You will not go to hell. So far, in my 53 years as a Christian, I have not heard of any church or pastor, whether it is a mega church or a smaller size church or any other church of any size for that matter, that dares to recklessly hold to the view that it is okay to take the mark of the beast, except for Joseph Prince, whom I've shown to be utterly reckless in the teaching of many of his other doctrines. My suspicion that Sadhu Sundar Selvaraj was referring to New Creation Church in both the videos is somewhat confirmed by what Joseph Prince said in the short video.
What's going to happen when a believer, under pressure or whatever, he renounces, you know, his faith or Jesus and all that? We're not to judge who is saved, who is not. But the thing is that if he renounces even his faith, does he become unsaved? Mm. All right? So if he can, then what Adam did is more powerful again than what Jesus did.
Joseph Prince teaches that even if a believer renounces his faith or renounces Jesus or disowns Jesus, he will not lose his salvation and will still be saved. This is a teaching from the pit of hell. Joseph Prince's teachings goes directly against the teaching of the Apostle Paul in 2 Timothy 2:11 to 13, the Apostle John in Revelation 14:9 to 12, and the Lord Jesus himself in Matthew 10:33. Let's take a thorough look at 2 Timothy 2:11 to 13. The statement I want you to take note is in verse 12b. If we disown him, he will disown us. Who are the we in verse 12b? Not the non-believers, but believers. If we say that the first four we in verses 11 to 12a refer to believers and they do, then to be consistent, we must also say that the last two we in verses 12b and 13 must refer to believers. Furthermore, Paul is the one who wrote the letter of 2 Timothy. When Paul wrote we, he included himself in all the six we from verses 11 to 13. Is Paul a Christian or non-Christian? A Christian, of course. So here is the definite possibility that a believer once owned by Christ can be disowned by him on the day of judgment. And even the great but humble Apostle Paul is not excluding himself from the possibility of disowning Christ, as he used the word we in verse 12b. Now, I want you to look at verse 13a. If we are faithless, he will remain faithful. Does this mean that whatever we do, even though we are faithless, and even if we turn away from Christ as an apostate and renounce him, Jesus will not break off the relationship and that he will remain faithful to us? Verse 13a is what Joseph Prince loves to quote to support his case that even though we are faithless and renounce Christ, Christ will still be faithful to us. But this is not what it means. If one reads the entire verse 13, it is quite clear that Jesus will remain faithful to himself and his principle, rather than to us, if we are faithless, for he cannot disown himself. Though we may change and become faithless, Jesus will not, for he cannot disown himself. Meaning, he cannot disown himself and his principle. What is the principle? The principle is already established in verse 12b. If we disown him, he will also disown us. We must remember that the principle is already stated and settled in verse 12b, that if we disown him, he will also disown us. And even if it means that if we are faithless and disown Christ, Christ will not disown us, assuming that was true in verse 13a, it will bring verses 11 to 13 into contradiction. One moment, the passage says, Christ will disown us if we disown him, in verse 12b. And the next moment, it says, Christ will not disown us if we are faithless and disown him, in verse 13a. Once there is an internal contradiction in a passage, the suggested interpretation has to be ruled out, as the Word of God cannot contradict itself. So clearly, verse 13a cannot be interpreted as Christ will not disown us no matter what, because verse 12b had already explicitly stated that he would disown us if we disown him. If God does not disown such a person, he would be disowning himself and his principle by going against his word in verse 12b. Joseph Prince by teaching that Christ will not disown us if we disown him, makes Jesus a liar because of what he said in Matthew 10:33. But whoever disowns me before others, I will disown before my Father in heaven. Joseph Prince teaching that Christ will not disown us contradicts Christ's own teaching in Matthew 10:33 that he will disown us if we disown him. What Jesus said in Matthew 10:33 is quoted by Paul in 2 Timothy 2:12b. So, both Jesus and Paul are on the same page regarding the issue. Who were these people spoken to in Matthew 10:33? They were not unbelievers, but believers, because Jesus spoke these words in Matthew 10:33 to his 12 disciples. Matthew 10:5 gives the context. From Matthew 10, verse 5 to verse 33, Jesus was speaking to believers who were his 12 disciples. So when Jesus said in Matthew 10:33, "But whoever disowns me before others, I will disown before my Father in heaven," who was he speaking to? Not to unbelievers, but to his 12 disciples. Jesus was speaking directly to them that if anyone of the 12 were to disown him, he would disown them. One of them, Judas, disowned Jesus by betraying him. And Jesus will disown him on the day of judgment. This debunks Joseph Prince's once righteous, forever righteous doctrine. Because if a believer disowns Christ, Christ will disown him. This simply means that the salvation he gains is now lost. Finally, let's come back to the two videos of Sadhu Sundar Selvaraj and the one video of Joseph Prince. Putting all these three videos together, Joseph Prince is teaching that even if one renounces or disowns Christ or take the mark of the beast, Christ will not disown him and he will not go to hell. Joseph Prince is paving the way for the masses of Christians to be on their road to hell, having been deceived that even if they were to renounce or disown Christ by taking the mark of the beast, especially during the period of the Great Tribulation, they will not lose their salvation. Taking the mark of the beast, which is equivalent to renouncing or disowning Christ, is an act that carries eternal consequences, and anyone who does so is hopelessly lost. That's why the Apostle John had to warn Christians in Revelation 14, 9 to 12, not to take the mark of the beast, but to endure suffering and remain faithful to Jesus. If they give in to pressure and take the mark of the beast, their salvation, once again, will be eternally lost. With what I've laid out about the toxic teachings of Joseph Prince that can send the multitudes to hell, if people still choose to follow and continue to embrace his teachings, they will only have themselves to blame when they, like him, are cast into the eternal fires of hell.